every single place where the government comes to the
Welcome back to another video. Today, let us discover the history behind of this magnificent St. Catherine Church in Eindhoven. The neo-Gothic building was designed by Pierre Cuypers, a Dutch architect, and considered an early highlight in his career. The construction began in 1861 and was completed in 1867. The architect Cuypers incorporated in this design many ideas about symbolism. The many rose windows refer to St. Catherine, whose attribute is a wheel. The most striking feature of the church are the two towers, both of which are 73 meters high and are different in shape according to example from the French Gothic, a so-called male and a female towers, with a name David Tower and Mary's Tower. In 1942 and 1944, the church was badly damaged by bombings. After the war, a restoration followed. The old windows, which had been lost, were replaced by stained glass. St. Catherine Church has been a national monument since 1972. In 1974, the church was transferred to the municipality of Eindhoven with the agreement to have another 50 years for worship. 1980 and 1982, a major restoration was needed, and in 2000, there was a large-scale restoration. In 2003, hundreds of skeletons were found during excavations under the square. Archaeological excavations in different areas of the modern city, such as the city castle, the Church of St. Catherine, and the city gate, have provided important new information about the city of Eindhoven and its citizens in the Middle Ages. Remains of buildings made of stone and wood, road, ditches, animal bones, pottery, and all kinds of tools are revealing where and how people lived, what they ate and drank, and what was traded. He was part of the skeleton found during a small-scale test excavation in 2002. The DNA, which had been preserved in the teeth that he was a 10-year-old boy, he was named Marcus van Eindhoven, since there was a coin found in his skeleton stamped with a portrait of Saint Mark. Marcus regained some of his lost identity through the extensive reconstruction of his face, his clothes, his history, where he was a boy that must have come from a high-status family. Christians' objects from various excavations were found. To the left, it is a metal funeral wreath from the old cemetery in the 19th century, and to the right is a copper basin from the village in the 13th century. Such basins were probably used by priests for washing hands just before celebrating Mass. Fragments of a brick church building were also found, including parts of the chandelier tree bronze candle holders. Some of the deceased were given objects in their grave. Sometimes that was a rosary beads of bones, glass, gilt, or amber. Coins and tokens are often found in medieval churches. Some are intentionally given to the deceased, including the glass pane lid of the coffin was also found during the excavation. Christian objects from various excavations were found, such as the pipe clay statuettes, pilgrim badge, a wooden butter stump with the image of the Holy Lamb of God, dress accessories, and hexagonal lower part of a bronze chalice. In addition to numerous human skeleton remains during the excavation, approximately 10,000 pottery fragments were found. And with the aid of such fragments, a number of graves can be dated from 13th to 19th century. During the excavation, dozens of fragments of gravestones were found. The largest fragment is this one, dating back from around 1500. A woman approximately 40 years old, dating back 1650 to 1850, with a height of 150 centimeters was found. Through the extensive reconstruction, her lost identity has regained back to her. The same with this 9-year-old boy, dating back to 1600, he was buried with coffin, he's holding 5 coins in his left hand, and wore beads around his neck. The one-hour hand from St. Catherine Church in 1645 was found. This church clock is first mentioned in the Eindhoven town year 1555 to 1556. This is the little chapel of St. Catherine with the church memorabilia back in the days. Tabernacle Doors, also known as Sacrament House, is a mostly richly decorated safe on the altar, is also preserved. The organizer of the church showcasing the collection of things that photographers, artists, and designers have in common by using this iconic image of the St. Catherine Church. Big Ben in London, Eiffel Tower in Paris, St. Catherine Church in Eindhoven is the city's famous landmark in the Netherlands. The church has two organs, the large organ built in 1936 with 5,723 pipes. It is one of the largest Dutch organ. The second organ at the sacristy is a smaller neo-Gothic altar organ.